605 kilometers from here in this direction to the north is the Zagreb, which is the capital of Croatia, and 55 kilometers more to north is Krapina. And in Krapina we made this museum, which is called Museum of Krapina Neanderthals, and in English it is Krapina Neanderthal Museum, and from this we made this Kraniamus, which is a sign. Museum belongs to the group of museums called Musei Hrvatskog Zagorja. That's a five museums from this region. Co-author with me on this project and realization of museum was Jakov Radovčić, who is curator of this collection of Krapina bones, which is kept in Zagreb in Natural History Museum. And I'm an architect, which was my job was making architecture, display, and graphic design. And as you can see, I'm don't wear black, and you'll see later why. So, Krapina collection, that's a picture which we take in one day. We need one day to arrange this. Is the still the biggest collection of Neanderthal bones in Neanderthal world today, with 900 bones, which belongs to more than 30 persons, and there's a stone tools and flora as well. Dragutin Bogdanovich Kamberger was the person who discovered this site in year 1899, more than 100 years ago. From that time there was an idea to make a museum on the site, and just in the 1967 there was opened provisional museum called Museum of Evolution, because it was social time in Croatia and Marxistic ideas. And at the end of last century, in the name of 100 years of discovery, in 1997 we start to make a project for this museum. That's Gorjanović Kamberger as well. On the site of Krapina Neanderthal, there is not a cave, what visitors mostly expect to see, because it collapsed. And because of this, we have so much bones, because there was kept under that collapsed cave. The initial idea was to make, in fact, that was missing, to have a cave. But we didn't like to have a museum near the site. So we choose, the site is on that side, and on another side of this hill, and we find one peaceful valley with a stream, and we like to put the museum here. And it is put across the valley, and it close the valley, and there's no, you can't pass through the valley anymore. And we make, in fact, something what is missing there. So some cave, let's say, situation. And that's how it looks. The whole building is made from one material, it's concrete. And the concrete was the beginning of when it was reinvented at the end of 19th century, was called artificial stone. And that's the reason why I chose this material. And it is just this facade is covered in the sandstone, the same sand like it was the Krapina cave. The form and shape of this space was based after the caves which are common to Neanderthal wall. So here's some pictures of that, and here's one model which is near the site, which is kept small model. So you see that there is always always a huge slab over the entrance, and there's no grass. So we make, I make the building on this way, and the whole building is in fact covered with ground, and you just have this, let's say, this in fact, just a little, let's say, architecture, which you can see. And the stream. The stream is kept, you see here the line of valley before, and stream was taken, and canal was right under the building, and here you must to, when you enter, go across the stream. So you see here in the section how it looks, huge, let's say, cave, and after, in the backstage, is the space where the exhibition continues. So that's that channel in front, and you must go across the river, like across the Rubicon, and when you go across, you are in one new world. And then you have a glass, like a mirror, and like Alice in the Wonderland, you must go through that glass. And in the glass, there is a reflection of a wood, and as well you have a reflection of yourself entering. And that's a combination. And when you enter, you see that you are in the cave. That cave made, as I tell you before, from the concrete. It has just some modern way of let's say, shaping the cave, and just colored. The concrete here is just colored with a yellow brown color, like that sand. And it was that mirror through which you enter start to be an huge screen on which you start to can watch the movie specially made for this museum, and starting the story about the Krapina Neanderthals. That means that all the scenes are made according to what we can find, what discover from the bones, stories about what can happen to that Krapina Neanderthal population. And mostly the scenes are filmed from the backside of a cave, so that in fact, when you are looking, you have experience that you are in the cave, in the back, and start to be inhabited and live together with the Neanderthals. So that was the idea just from the beginning, to give all the visitors 125,000 years back to be and to start to live with the Neanderthals, so that they can understand better what will be shown in the continuation of the exhibition. And in the stone, there is just carved one small opening through which you go in that backstage, in which is continuation of the line, the story. Floor is very important part of a display. You always have some indication because the exhibition is made like a time machine, and you always have orientation in what time you are. And on the beginning, we start with the 23rd of August 1899, the day when Borjanovic came to Krapina, and there we have a scenes of Krapina, how it looks, and the stories, what helped the man who sent him the bones, that man called Gregoric, who sent him bones 5 years ago. He didn't have time, and because there was not interesting bones from animals. And when he came on that day, he goes to the site and find one human thing. And just a few days later, he come back and continued the excavation. We have captions, because we are small nation. We have just 4.5 million people, and they are in Croat, and then in English and German. And there is always one picture which is connected about what is the story in that room. We have an audio guy, which is now in 9 languages, and some small languages with our neighbors from which we are oriented, like Slovenian, Czech, Hungarian, not, and yet normally all the main languages. The third room is that in which is the story about the search for ancestors. And in that room you have on a floor against the years which correlate to that things which are shown, and that yellow line which takes you from, like a billiard ball from one to another part of the story. Architecture is here, because I'm an architect, I always like to advertise architecture. So architecture is here, something like a background for that story. That's about Renaissance, interest in humans, first start. So here's Brunelleschi founding house in Florence. And it finished with a Paxton, model of Paxton, Crystal Palace, in which it shows engineering way of thinking, and which is the same in this Huxley, showing how showing and connecting the evolution of apes and man, humans. In this room, we show diversity of doctrines. Some wrong decisions, which thinking about which was in that time, but that's the way how we show the way and evolution of thinking about the who we are and how where we come. And then you come to the date of when Gorjanić a few days later came and start to dig. And here is this diorama made from two elements which we have. One is his sketch of a site, and another based on a photography which you saw earlier, and just Gorjanović, like a prominent, is in a sculpture, he is in front, so you can have the image of this starting discovery. Then we continue with this about Gorjanović, then the story about what he, how he explained in that time, and he was the man who just a few years after discovery of Rengen, first to use the Rengen rays for antique bones to explain the structure of these bones. So because of this, we have here one virtual anthropology, which shows how we now can use today's science and today's possibilities to explain the bones. And after, there's three sections, main sections of the exhibition, and after all of these three sections, you have these info places, stands, and here you can get some more informations about the part which you passed. Then you can have, here is a game, questions, and if you answer good, there's five questions. If you answer of each good, then you can get the golden artifact diploma at the end. In the museum, it's forbidden to take pictures, but you can choose some scenes from a display and make your picture. And at the end, of course, buy the picture. Because we like, because of this, we don't allow to take your picture. To get some extra money for the museum. And we have a ticket with the barcode, and every visitor is indicated with this barcode, so at the end he knows who made good answers, or who have pictures made and collected. After that, we're going back to the early beginnings, to the 13.7 billion years, and we start with the Big Bang. And in 3.5 minutes, you have short cosmic evolution, which covers time up to the formation of the Earth at 4.5 billion years before. And then we start with the, in fact, third part. And one, in fact, new architecture complex is open with double spiral, in which is shown in the first part, is shown chemistry evolution. We have the smoke, as you see. Then we have new extra information on the floor. We have a 24-hour watch. What will be happen if the evolution of the Earth belongs just 24 hours? So that you can be more familiar with that things what, in which time happened, not to calculate these billion years and so on and so on. After we have addition of the floating continents and the names of eras and catastrophe, and everything is shown in the floor. There is a copy of footprints of a man. You can walk across it. There's a lot of there is shown Heraclitus' four elements story about world, fire, earth, and so on. And here is that smoke. So we have a smoke machine, like in disco. And here is that turning point. The first part is that chemistry evolution, and then you change the direction of moving, and here is the vertical, and the only opening in a museum through which goes a huge DNA model. On the walls you can see these murals, how like old frescoes from that time, how the fossils which are shown here look when they was alive. The fossils are strong, so they are open and you can touch them and feel them. And the cool story is shown like in this drawing, like this, very simple drawing of eras. So we have for all each era some prominent figure, some prominent fossil to show here. And when you come to the 18 million years, then one proposal come down from the tree on the earth, and here start the line of hominids which goes up. And in the end, you in fact come to the first floor. Didn't find it, but you come to the first floor, and here is the copy of Krapina, as we think that it could be looked like, Krapina cave, which was really built and covered with original sand, like this kind of sand on the cave. And here we have a diorama with thermoplastic figures made by famous French sculptor Elizabeth Annette, in the scenes which you can see before on a movie. Okay, let's go to the better. Here is just one small artifact, which is 10 times bigger, shown like a sculpture, and we have the souvenirs like made for him in a half size as well. Then we have interactive eyes. Before there was an interactive body figure in which you can find the illness of the Neanderthals. Then you can see the wine and animals which live together with the Neanderthals and find the many of what they eat, shown in these numbers, rituals. The room where all the Neanderthals are together with the Krapina in the center and the other in the back. And that's the shape of the museum. The organic form of architecture derives from the previous wishes, but that was just what happened in my design. And it was what associate me on uterus or embryo. I think that Dr. Fiala will agree with me. But some other find that it is like a snail or a human brain or the structure of DNA. And there's a lot of artists who participate in this exhibition, and that gives another quality of this. And I have a still colleague, Vlasta, who will continue. We don't have time for a film, I'm afraid.
The new museum of the Krapina Neanderthals, which is open on the February 2010, has been the most visited museum destination in Croatia, and there have been more than 150,000 visitors in the first year. Till today, museum has 250,000 visitors. The museum exhibition is well arranged for individual and group visits and enables for all age groups to have an interactive communication with the museum specimens and the interesting multimedia elements. Guided tours are adjusted for the various visitors. The museum also organizes scientific meetings and seminars, thematic lectures, exhibitions, various workshops, and participates in cultural tourism events like a museum night, week of Kekavian culture, Krapina Day, International Museum Day, Day of Planet Earth, etc. The museum cooperates with the local community, organizing cultural and tourist events, and also stimulates other local participants for the further development of additional services that are related to the museum exhibition. Visitors are also offered specialist workshops that supplement knowledge from individual fields. The interactive aids are adapted primarily for the family visits, and the museum stimulates visits by this particular type of group. The museum organized numerous workshops for visitors where they can make artifacts, light a fire by using flints, manufacture clothing of the Neanderthals from Krapina. A lot of schools organize their visits as an addition to the curriculum and conducting fieldwork for students. Besides regular guide visits, the museum provides expert study cases on the site and in the museum, organize different workshops and lectures. The most famous workshop is the Summer Geology School, which is held every August and explores various techniques used by researchers at the paleontological and geological sites. The groups participating in the workshops are mostly primary school children, and the most important outcome we see in raising awareness for natural sciences. The school has been recognized for its efforts to promote science and research and was given the support from our Ministry of Culture, and many distinguished companies have been the sponsors. We also organize winter workshops for very young children from the region, trying to give them the first knowledge about the prehistoric life. The contents are presented in the form of various plays and interactive games. The days of Dragutin Borjanović Kramberger are intended for students, and many lectures and round tables have been organized for them. The Krapina Neanderthal Museum has already received several awards, in Shanghai at AviCon competition in the category of the Museum Multimedia, our InfoKioska awarded, and the interactive DVD won the National Prize for Innovation in Corporate Tourism. The museum received the recognition by Regional Tourism Board for the best tourist office in 2010 and was given the charter of the town of Krapina for its contribution to the promotion of culture and tourism of the town. The museum received the Krapina Zagorje County plaque for its contribution and for the promotion of the region, and also the Croatian Tourist Board Annual Award for 2010. The authors of the project and realization of the Krapina Neanderthal Museum, paleontologist Jako Radovčić and architect Želko Kovačić, received the Croatian Museum Society Annual Award for 2010. Also, our museum has been running for the 2012 European Museum of the Year Award, organized by European Museum Forum. Thank you for your attention, and please come to Krapina and our amazing museum. Thank you.